y'all, good morning. It is your girl Sunray coming at you guys with another Daily Manna episode number 4. Today's Daily Manna is going to be titled Count It All Joy, okay? But before I get into this, you guys know that I like to usher us in with praise and worship, okay? So this is a song that was on my spirit immediately when I woke up, so I knew this is a song that God wanted me to lead today. Maybe someone needs some of the words that are going to be spoken in this song, so I don't want to take any longer because today is going to be a long one, all right? So hold on, let's get started. To fall asleep, there was so much on my mind, searching for that peace I could not find. So then I kneeled down to pray, praying, help me please. He said, you don't have to cry, 'cause I'll fulfill all your needs. As soon as I stop worrying how the story ends, when I let go and I let God have his way, that's when things start happening. And I stop looking at back then, when I let go and I let God have his way. Hallelujah, Lord God. I thank you, Lord God, this morning for allowing me to usher your people into praise and worship, God. I pray that as the day goes along, Lord God, that you reveal what it is for people to be known in this time, God. God, I pray that people are blessed by this daily manna, by this spiritual nourishment, God. And I pray that it opens their eyes, Lord God, that when trials come, they just need to count it all joy. Just give it all to you. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen. As soon as I stop worrying how the story ends, and I let him have, that's when, oh, God, for your plans are greater than the plans that I have for my life. Oh, shut up, oh, shut up, shut up, shut up. Let go, and let God. Let go. To somebody out there, you just gotta know that God has a greater plan in store for you. Do not despise those closed doors. It's God opening you into your new. Hallelujah, Lord God. You gotta let go and let God. Whatever it is, just give it to him in this hour. Hallelujah, God. He knows your heart. Even with tears in my eyes, y'all. Lord. Ooh. Hallelujah, God. The devil cannot steal your joy. Hallelujah. Ooh. Soon as I stop worrying how the, 'cause he said that he can do what? For he knows the plans he has for us. He has plans to not harm us, but he has plans to do what, body? He has plans to prosper us. Just let God do what his will. Hallelujah, God. Ooh. Let God have his way. Soon as I stop worrying, oh, cast myself aside, God, as soon as, hallelujah, God. Ooh, my eye burning, y'all. That's why I keep doing this, but I'm going to get into today's word. Because we already have 5 minutes. I told y'all today going to be a long one. But this is needed. Oh, dear Lord, I just thank you, God. All right, y'all. So today's prophetic word is titled Count It All Joy. Now, it's funny how this came about because yesterday I was in my one-on-one with my girl Jay. And we were talking and she was like, I also feel like this is for you. So she was talking about James, you guys. James 1, but she was specifically talking about the part about wavering faith, you know, like how sometimes we can be double-minded, like we trust in God but we don't trust him at the same time, right? Boom. So later on that day, another one of my friends, they spoke the same scripture to me, but they were talking about the count it all joy part. And so it's so interesting how God brought it all together, because I'm like, yeah, God, you know, in some moments, you know, there are those things like where it's like, you know, I just understand that it's a trial. And that's why I never despise when something happens, right? But y'all, first I'm going to read the scripture for y'all, and then I'll go into what I want to talk about with that, okay? So let's go to James 1, 2, and God been showing me 1, 2, 3 so much, you know. So we're going to talk about James 1, verses 2 through 3. It's talking about faith and endurance. Dear brothers and sisters, when troubles of any kind come your way, consider it an opportunity for great joy. For you know that when your faith is tested, your endurance has a chance to grow. And I'm just going to read 4. So let it grow. For when your endurance is fully developed, you will be perfect and complete, needing nothing. Amen. So when you allow your endurance, when you allow yourself to still have faith in those enduring trials, you will be complete and you will be lacking nothing. So y'all, yesterday, after my one-on-ones, I looked at my phone. Something told me to check my email. And I asked God this morning, and I was like, God, do you want me to share this with them? And God's like, I need you to be as transparent as possible. I feel like some people, you know, they're like, oh, like I go through certain things. Like some prophets on YouTube, they may say they go through things, but they don't tell y'all exactly what it is. Me, I'm going to tell the tea. Why? Because, like, I mean, it's what I'm going through. So yesterday, you guys, I was let go from my new assignment. I got an email saying, like, you are no longer assigned to your middle school due to inconsistency with your attendance. Now, y'all know that I was out because I was sick this week, right? And so when I first got the email, I just froze. I was like, whew, okay, that's unexpected. And, you know, I started to shed tears. And I was like, dang, God, okay. But there's this thing, like I tell people, it's like God don't want me to get angry. God don't want me to be sad, because I'll shed tears and instantly I'm like, okay, I know God got better, right? But yesterday was very different too, because there was a greater peace. It was like a relief almost. It was like, wow, God, I can finally focus. And that's all I saw in the spirit when I was just sitting there staring into space, wondering how to process this. All I saw was focus, focus. And I started just to think, like, because me working at the school, like, you know, I love working with the students, y'all. But can I be honest with y'all for a second? It got to be very frustrating some days because I wasn't able to teach 100%. I spent majority of my time classroom management, behavioral issues, because the teacher never set up effective classroom management. So it's not like the students were being focused during class. So I have to be babysitting students, like monitoring them, all of that, as opposed to actually teaching them, you know? And so I was like, well, God, you did tell me you wanted me to be a teacher. I thought this was the route. And I guess I misunderstood. God does want me to be a teacher, but it's what I'm doing for y'all right now. Teaching y'all through my life, teaching y'all through the word of God, you know? The true word, not prosperity gospel or anything like that, but the true word of God. You know what I'm saying? What we all encounter and go through on a daily basis. And I'm like, okay, God, because with me working at that school for such a long period in my day, you guys, like, when I come home, I wouldn't have, like, enough time to dedicate to ministry. I got people asking me for prayer. I got people asking me for one-on-ones. I got tutoring sessions. I have my tutoring business on the side, too, and I wasn't being fully, I didn't have enough time to fully prepare for some sessions. And obviously, like, I'm a great tutor, so I can go off the top of my head, but I love to be prepared because it just makes the session more effective, you know? So it was like, okay, God, like, I'm seeing, like, you're giving me the opportunity to focus. Like, I am covered by your, I'm covered in your grace. Like, this is a good thing, you know? And I just replied back to the email, like, okay, thank you, like, whatever, like, you know? And so I was just like, God, like, you know, I have to count it all joy. And I'm speaking about my personal testimony because, one, I feel some people can relate, but also, too, like, I want to show you guys, like, God never promised that we would not go through trials. God, if anything, said that, you know, nothing that comes, no weapon formed shall prosper. God said, if anything, that he will give us the strength to endure. You know what I'm saying? It's like when hard times happen, you don't pray away the hard times. Like James said, you count it all joy, because I'm just sitting there and I'm like, God, I can't wait to see what this trial, actually it's a relief, will turn into. Because, you know, yeah, I could sit here and be like, God, like, how I'm going to pay my rent? How I'm going to do this? How am I? I'm like, I don't care. I'm really not worried about it, because it's like, God, like, it's going to happen, you know? Hold on, y'all, my nose. But yeah, it's like one of those things where I'm just like, God, like, I'm not worried, because I know that God has plans to prosper me. Ever since I've been in Houston, God has elevated my life. Ever since I've been in this promised land, like, I have not wanted nor needed for anything. So I'm not worried about this. You know, I feel like this is like God seeing, okay, can you still endure when things were going good and now you got a little bit of a, you know, can you keep going? And it's like, yes, God, I will. Because guess what? When I had nothing and things got worse, I still trusted you. And like I say, God can remove things, but I'm not praising God for the things. I'm not following after God for the things. I'm not on YouTube for the things. I'm on YouTube because God told me to be on YouTube. I'm just grateful to be a vessel. You get what I'm saying? So it's like, hey, God, like, I'm still grateful for the relationship I have with you, because when I had nothing, you were my everything. And now that I have what I need, God, you're still my everything. You get what I'm saying? So I just really pray that this encourages somebody. And I want to tell somebody, count it all joy, always remember, life will get better, it's gonna get better, no matter the weapon, it will not prosper. Always remember, it's gonna get better. Say it with me, y'all. It's gonna get better. You don't know how you're gonna pay your rent. It's gonna get better. You don't know where your next provision is coming from. It's gonna get better. Yes. Woo, Lord. And that was the song that was on my spirit yesterday. And I thought that's the song God wanted me to lead in today. But God, like, literally had that first song, Let Go, Let God, by Dwayne Woods on my heart. But y'all, I'm happy because like I said, even as I speak right now, it's like I'm happy because it was a part of me that was tired of teaching in the school system with teachers that didn't care, and also with like a system where I literally was like a babysitter, you know? Like, I enjoyed my first day at my school, my new school, last week, but I also did spend majority of my time like behavioral, you know? And so it's like God's like, this is not what I have for you. I don't know what was around the corner. And I know how God worked. Like, he pulled me out of stuff right before stuff happened. Like, as soon as I left my last school, things started to happen. You know what I mean? And so it's like, okay, God, you're putting me out of the way for something. Now, I've already decided that I'm going to bet on myself. I'm focusing on my ministry. Like, I believe this is God's call for me to go into full-time ministry now. And that's the thing. I was like, God, because I was talking to God about a month ago. I was like, God, like, I feel like, y'all, that's nobody but the devil. I'm just kidding. It was my alarm. But it was literally Oh wow, that's my alarm. Lord, God wants me to go into full-time ministry. Oh, say the double say. Ah, the double say the double. Y'all, God wants me to go into full-time ministry. Because my alarm just went off. That's why the other video cut off. So I'm going to have to edit this. Or not edit it. I'm just going to combine the videos together and then y'all just going to see. But, or should I just do a part one? Nah, we'll just put it all together. It's just going to be a long video overall. But yes, y'all. As I was saying, God wants me to, like, I was just saying to God a few months ago, like, God, do you want me to go into full-time ministry anytime soon? But what I was finna say is, it's like, I wasn't doing that because I'm like, well, God, I got this assignment. And God knows how I am. Like, he has to pull me out of an assignment. I'm not gonna just walk away unless he, like, urges it heavy on my spirit. And I felt like an urge, like I needed to leave, but I just wasn't sure. So I feel like this was God's way. Like, he gave me an assignment and snatched it right back because he's like, baby girl, I need you to focus. You know what I'm saying? That's all I was saying, focus, focus. So I'm doing full-time ministry. And also too, I'm betting on myself as well in regards to my tutoring business. There were things that I was supposed to be doing, but I never really had the time to. And now I'll have the time to do it. So I'm like, praise God, because I'll be able to, you know, get my tutoring company out there a little bit more. Respond to people. Like, I know someone emailed me about tutoring their high school son. I definitely saw the email, but I've just been busy. But now I got free time. So look. But y'all, God is just so good. So I'm seeing where God is taking me. I am not. Like I said, I'm happy. Oh, shut up, bullshit. I'm happy. I'm so happy. I'm happy, y'all. I'm happy. Because it's like, this is something that I've wanted. But you know how sometimes you'll have like a lingering desire, but you're just not sure? Because I care about the kids. I care about teaching. But it's like, God, that was too much. You know what I'm saying? And it's like, now God is going to enable me to be able to teach y'all more and to teach my tutoring students more. Like, pray more, spend more time with him. Like I said, I ain't worried about how my bills going to get paid. None of that. That's elementary. I'm not worried about that because I have been there. Like, God had me leave my job February 14th, 2020. Right before the pandemic, okay? And I remember when I left my job, because my job was a job with the state. I worked for a university. So they took money into a retirement fund, but the retirement fund was only for Wisconsin. And I knew I wasn't staying in Wisconsin forever. So when I left, I had opted out. And I was like worried. I'm like, God, like the pandemic just happened. Boom. $5,000 checks show up on my doorstep from the retirement fund. So I was able to provide for myself. So it's like, God, I ain't worried. I know a miracle on its way, because it always is, like, you know. But I just really wanted to tell you guys in a very long-winded manner to count it all joy, always remember life will get better. It's gonna get better. No matter the weather, it will not prosper. All right. So, I pray that this blesses you guys. I was gonna cancel my one-on-ones for today because, like, y'all, like, but look, we're gonna speak against that because I feel like I can do it. You know what I mean? And I got time to still go back to sleep before and whatnot, so I can nurse myself back completely. But I am so excited to see you guys in the one-on-ones and just to talk to you guys. Yeah. I'll talk to y'all later, though. Y'all have a blessed day, because I know that I am.